So however value on that could work. It's a bit more than nostrils there. A little bit more. There isn't exactly a nose ridge width, is there? Gonna look too alien. It's too like high and out cheekbones. Yeah, I don't even know how to do these lips. A lot of these sliders seem to, from my perspective, do much the same thing, just over and over again. Clearly I don't have an eye for creating characters in these games anymore. Probably not ever. This one looks like it'll actually do something. See, I don't know why the slider is called position. The mouth is staying exactly where it is, it's just changing the shape of the mouth. width at least does as advertised. And this will probably be what I'm looking for. And, no, it's still just... This one is accurate. The mouth is staying still, but the distance from the chin changes, right? I wouldn't call that slight, I'd call that inverted. But I suppose previous slight or fuckery might have caused that effect. Pupils, here we go. Give her the ridiculously big eye pupil, big pupils rather. Perhaps not the ridiculously big ones. I like how you can change to individual pupil color and size. That's nice. Little details. Hair, facial hair. These are some amazing hairs. I think they actually give you options for eyebrows now. I don't remember that being a thing before. Probably just gonna go with the bees. Sure, canceling out of that menu cancels it, but canceling out of the skin color? Nope, that doesn't do it. Aw, oh, they'll let you go bald, but they won't let you have a beard as a lady. You can even change your eyelash color? What is this? Naturally, we're going purple here. The beauty mark. The double beauty mark, but way too big. Freckles, is that? Freckles? Glasses. I'm not sure she'd have glasses or even a monocle. Though the monocle is pretty tempting.